Hello, how's it going? We got another Black Ops 4 update. It was kind of a big update, but really not much to show, so let's just get into it. Well, there was a few cool things added. So, first up, the zombies. The second gauntlet arrives. This is first on PS4. If you're on Xbox right now, you can play the previous gauntlet, which was the unsinkable. Basically, you play 30 rounds and each round is a new challenge. You complete the challenge and you get XP. If you can make it all the way, you will get a special calling card with a golden zombie head on it. It's really not all that special, but you do get some XP. And on the new one, which is only on PlayStation right now, you can get this cool emblem, which is like a skull, Roman type theme with some blood all over it. Everyone gets the Cap 40 gun, Cap 45, that is if you rank up your contraband thing. What that means for zombies is the mystery box has been updated. So it has the MP40, the Grav, the Damon XB, the SWAT Rift, and the Cap 45. Here's the thing, to get the Cap 45, you need to grind in multiplayer or blackout. So if you're a hardcore zombies player and you don't like to play multiplayer, well, that kind of sucks because you're not going to have the Cap 45 to be able to level it up. Okay, so the only workaround really is, I guess, maybe play some blackout. They added some new pretty fun modes in there and, you know, it kind of goes by fairly quickly. Kind of sucks that hardcore zombie players, you know, you got to play multiplayer for right now, unfortunately, to get that Cap 45. Camo progression will also become available in the armory for the MP40, the Grav, and progression and customization for loot weapons available in the armory as those weapons are unlocked in the black market. So they got the usual gameplay improvements, bug fixes, stability updates, all that stuff. Link down below to all the bug fixes for zombies. And Treyarch has said they're still planning on updating support for the mastery camos. So that includes gold, diamond, dark matter for multiplayer. So you can have that in zombies. So that should be very, very soon. I don't know, maybe later today in a couple days. They just said very soon. As well as support for the mastercrafts, reactive camos, and black market camos in the armory. All right, so that's the major stuff with zombies. Next up is blackout. They have a limited time mode. It's called ambush. The weapons are sniper rifles, melee attacks, and launchers only. It's I don't know, kind of a weird combo. Hey, but if you're looking to get some sniper practice in blackout, here you go, looking for, you know, sniper kills. There is, you know, all the lethals are still there, like cluster bombs, acid bombs, all that stuff, still in there. So it's gonna make it kind of difficult. I'm not really sure, but I had a lot of fun in just a little bit of time that I played it. The other thing is a circle constantly advances with no delay between collapses. So it's gonna be pretty quick. More changes to the armor. They're always doing stuff with this, and they've made it actually pretty weak. Level 1 armor damage protection has been reduced from 30% to 15%, L2 from 40% to 25%, and level 3 from 50% to 35%. So it helps, armor helps, but not as much, 35% being the max. They've also removed explosive damage resistance from level 3 armor, making them less of a tank. Removed melee weapon damage reduction from the level 3 armor, so you could stab someone with level 3 and they wouldn't die right away, so that is gone. And they increased armor plates required to repair a single durability pip of level 3 armor from 1 to 2. So, is this perfect? Too soon to tell. I've said it before, you know, I feel like they should copy, you know, some other games, maybe like Fortnite, where the shield or armor is just make it like in, you know, quarters or half pieces. You can get one piece of armor that'll, you know, bring it up to 50%, and then you find another piece, and then that's it. Your full armor, none of this repairing, all that stuff. It just slows down the game, in my opinion, but let's see how it goes. You know, they'll leave it like this for a few weeks, get our feedback, and then I'm sure we're not gonna be happy, but there you go. At least level 3 armor has been knocked down a lot. The next annoying thing in the game, the no-skill kill, the concussion grenade. They have changed it. It's still in the game, unfortunately, in my opinion. But the facts are this: reduced status effect duration, reduced area of effect radius, reduced the throw distance, reduced opacity of the white flash when initially concussed. So when you're concussed, players now can use equipment. They can continue holding equipment, perform melee attacks, and they can even switch weapons. Reduced hip fire spread while concussed. That is actually a very, very big nerf in many, many ways. So I haven't been stunned yet. It is one of the most annoying things, was one of the most annoying things in the game. It was like a guaranteed kill, a no skill kill. And let's play it for a couple weeks, see how it goes. And maybe it is finally balanced. We'll see. Up next is the cluster grenade. That got a nerf. Increased time to detonate after impact and reduced the damage of many cluster grenade explosions. And on paper, that actually sounds okay. Multiplayer, really nothing major, but I did notice a few things. They did change the color of the numbers skin. So that used to be really, really cool. Red and black. It matches my new theme. I loved it. Now it's orange. Why is it orange on all the characters? At least the main body is orange, and there is still some parts that are red and black. And the only reason why I could think they did this is because people were getting confused and shooting their teammates. This was a big problem in hardcore. So now it's orange, and hopefully you guys do not team kill anymore or shoot your own teammates. And as I said earlier, the Cap 45 is available for everyone. So on Xbox PC, the Barbarian's special event has been added to the black market. 25 new tiers of loot to earn available in the special event stream below the existing Operation Absolute Zero stream. Rewards include new outfits, gestures, calling cards, reactive camo, and the Cap 45 fully auto pistol, so you can just play the game every day. You'll get it within 15 days, or you can just go outright and buy it. I've already got a guide how to get this weapon in diamond camo quick. Link to that guide down below. And for the featured playlist, they brought back Blackjack's gun game. And in that gun game, the Cap 45 is in there. They've added hardcore mosh pit, endurance chaos mosh pit is back, mercenary capture mosh pit, and safeguard are added to the featured category. The big thing that many of us were waiting for, the CWL playlist, the competitive playlist. Hey, here it is. Check it out. League play. Doesn't it look cool? Well, unfortunately, that's a mock-up. There's going to be a fourth tile coming soon for League play, the World League. I will have a link down below to the rules, but things are pretty different. For example, Ajax is banned, Torque is banned, Prophet Seeker is banned, Firebreaks Reactor Core is banned, Seraph cannot use her TAC deploy. Instead, you'd probably use a stun or a trophy system. The Square Streaks, many of them are banned, like the Dart and the RC. Link to the full rules down below. They haven't added it yet, and it has been pushed back to February, mid-February, so about 2 weeks, but they did give us a hint of some of the stuff to come. You'll also be able to earn multiplayer XP and black market tier progression as you play ranked, and support for teams and clans will also follow later in the 2019 season as feature additions to the World League Cup. So they've been promising clans before the game even came out. Don't hold your breath for this. They are taking their sweet time with it. So who knows, a couple months, I'm gonna assume. In the meantime, before the actual full-on competitive playlist comes out, Treyarch is planning to launch a limited time Pro Series Mosh Pit public match playlist later this week, where all players use the updated competitive rule set. It's pretty much going to be a place where you can dip your toes in there, practice, and just get a feel for it. It's not going to mean anything. It's going to be unranked and will not support skill-based matchmaking and will allow players to join matches in progress. Okay, so you can join this competitive playlist, and really, it's not going to mean anything. You can leave as you want, come and go. Really doesn't matter. You can fix up your classes. It's really just a way just to kind of sort of get the feel for it. You're not going to earn anything. There's not going to be any rankings. There won't be any punishment for leaving a game early. There's just no matchmaking. It'll be purely random. So that's kind of a great way to get introduced to it, actually. So that will probably be coming later this week, I assume. Definitely before the 2 weeks when they want to launch the full thing. All right, guys, so if you enjoyed these update videos, be sure to no-scope that like button, and I will keep you updated when they finally deploy all these cool new features like the clans and all that stuff. If you want to come hang out in the live streams, a link to my Twitch down below. On the left side there is the Epic Moments. Got some new Epic Moments coming soon, and on the right side, a brand new video.